Yes, so continuing with the lesson, the heavenly parasol, we learnt in the 24th paragraph that Meghavahana wishes from Lord Varuna that he wants to cross the Indian Ocean and his wish will be fulfilled. So what happens is, look into the paragraph 25. The following day, that's the next day, Meghavahana assembled his troops on the shore. The water swelled and crashed on the sand, and the soldiers trembled at its might. Meghavahana rode forward and plunged into the foaming ocean. All at once, the waters parted, and the king, smiling at his troops' astonishment, beckoned them to follow him. In this wondrous manner, Meghavahana reached Lanka and won over its king Vibhishana in the form of friendship. Look, one wish and everything is fulfilled. So here what happens is, the next day Meghavahana gets his troop ready, that is his army ready, and when they'll go near the ocean, when they are at the shore of the ocean, the water swell in the sand, there are waves in the ocean. These waves are hitting the shore, that is they hit the shore and they settle down. And what happens is, when they started moving, Meghavahana and his army started to walk, at that time the water was pulled in the sand, the way was made for them to cross the ocean. They cross the ocean, they go to Sri Lanka, and Sri Lanka was ruled by King Vibhishana, and they go over there, they have a very friendly relationship with King Vibhishana, and that is how Meghavahana becomes a king over there, and he stops the rule that people who commit a mistake will be killed. So killing of human beings also will be stopped at Sri Lanka. So look into the 26th paragraph. On returning home, Amrita Prabhu welcomed him and then looked around in confusion. Where is the parasol, my lord? She asked. It never leaves your side. So all the expeditions are done and now Meghavahana went home. So when when somebody returns home, and if you go alone, when you carry something with you and you go back alone without carrying the thing what was with you, we always question, where is it? So similarly, Amrita Prabha also asked Meghavahana, where is the parasol? The parasol will always be with you. It never left you alone. So now see what Meghavahana replies. It was never mine to keep, he answered. Yet the mark of favor shown to me by its divine owner will guide me through my life. As he spoke, the skies darkened as if the parasol was casting its shadow over him, even from its heavenly abode. So what the reply was, it was never mine to keep it with me. But I've learned one lesson from this parasol, that it's always good to be noble enough. And when he continued and ended this statement, it became very cloudy. And even in this cloudy weather, Meghavahana felt that the parasol is shining from up above the sky, even though the parasol was in the heaven. So the lesson we learned from this lesson, the heavenly parasol, is we always have to be noble and compassionate enough. Understood? Yes, thank you. So now, your work is to be to write down the glossary which is given on page number 5, and afterwards just below the glossary you can find the heading comprehension. Under that, exercise A, answer the following questions in one or two sentences each. I want you all to write down this in your classwork itself. You'll write the notes and the homework in the note classwork only. Thank you. So your classwork activity is, you have to copy down the glossary which is given on page number 5. All the meanings should be written. If one word has two meanings, I want you all to write both the meanings. And next, your homework will be written just below the glossary. I'm repeating it. You need to continue the homework after writing the meanings. And your homework is on page number 5, comprehension. Question A, that is, answer the following questions in one or two sentences each, and then come to page number 7, third main, language activity, the exercise under it. Fill in the blanks with appropriate prepositions. You have to fill in the blanks by choosing the correct preposition. And then come to page number 8, dictionary use. Under it, you have another question. Question A, choose the appropriate specialists given below in brackets for the following ailments. So there are specialists given in the brackets. You need to fill up the blanks. And then come to page number 9. You have 7th main, under which you have to fill in the blanks again. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate word chosen from the brackets. So this will be your homework. I'm repeating it for the last time. You need to write the homework once you write the meanings. Just after the meanings, start writing your homework. Thank you.